Ever wonder what the difference is between square and rectangular style filters versus that of circular screw-on filters? You know, besides the obvious, the overall shape of them. And this is a question that has come up quite a bit recently, and I felt that it warranted a video on the topic, as this is something that I really didn't hear much about until the last couple of months, with the ultimate question always being the same: which is better for outdoor photography, circular filters or square filters? And at a very high level, you might think the only difference between the two styles is simply the shape and your personal preference. Would you rather screw your filters on, or would you rather slide your filters in? But there's actually quite a bit more to it than that. So if you're looking to invest in a filter system, maybe it's your first filter system or a brand new filter system, and you're on the fence as to which style to jump into, I hope this video will shed some light on the differences between these two systems. So as far as the pros and cons are concerned for each of these systems, you know, when I first started to get this question a couple of months ago, I actually had to stop and think about it, because I actually use both styles, but I had to stop and think, you know, what do I like about each of these? Why do I still use both styles? Is there something I prefer over one over the other? And these are just the kind of the pros and cons that I came up with my personal workflow. This is definitely not the end all be all. I'm sure there's some things that I forgot, or some things that others might disagree with, but these are the things that I find beneficial and the things that I find as negatives, or I guess cons, on these different styles of systems. So as far as square and rectangular style filters are concerned, some of the pros that I've come up with, or I should say that I've experienced, is, and this is probably one of the biggest ones, is the fact that when you use these style of filters, they cover the entire lens and outward and beyond the lens as well. So you get very little vignetting with these style of filters, with square filters, with rectangular style filters. And these are, and that's probably one of the biggest benefits of these of this style, is that there is no vignetting. They're easier to use with a polarizer as well. So with the system that I use, the Nissi system, the polarizer actually has the adapter kit on it, and then you hook the adapter kit to it, and then you can slide the filters in front of the polarizer, and you still have access to rotate the polarizer wheel to whatever polarization that you want to apply for your particular image. They are easier to stack the filters. So these filters I find much easier to stack one in front of the other. So if you have the polarizer closest to your lens, and then maybe you have a graduated filter in front of that, or maybe you have a solid ND filter in front of that, it's very easy to stack these filters in front of one of the other. And they're also very easy to adapt to other lenses as well. So I kind of think of rectangular style and square style filters is a system that will kind of future-proof your workflow, if you will, because let's face it, we're all changing lenses, you know, fairly frequently. Maybe we're changing camera systems, and the overall filter sizes of your lenses is going to change probably every time that you change the lenses that you use. But these types of systems, square and rectangular style, you have like these adapter rings, or what do you call these? Not adapter. Yeah, I guess adapter rings. There's another ring, or another word for it that's escaping me right now. But these rings enable you to attach these types of setups to pretty much any type of filter thread. So that's really nice as well. Now, as far as just, you know, round filters are concerned, circular screw-on filters, one of the biggest benefits, in my opinion, is the fact that they're very easy to set up. They're very quick. And a lot of times that is the reason why I reach for these types of filters in my bag sometimes, is because I don't have a whole lot of time to, you know, maybe the conditions are unfolding very quickly, and I just want to grab a quick filter just to put on the lens real quick, screw it on. There's not a lot of setup. There's not a lot of fuss or anything like that. These are also very convenient to carry. They're lightweight. You can just put them in a small carrying case, and they're very durable as well, because screw-on filters always have some type of an edge banding around them. Whether it's aluminum or metal, I guess it varies on depending on which type of screw-on filter you use. But as you can see with these types of square filters, there's no edge banding around it. It's just pure glass. So if you drop one of these, the odds are pretty high that it's going to shatter. If you drop these, your odds are not quite as high that it's going to shatter. A lot of times these will survive that type of a fall. And one of the other big benefits is the fact that there's not going to be any light leakage with these types of screw-on filters. It's going to screw on, it's going to make a nice seal around your lens. You don't have to worry about any kind of light getting in between the filters or anything like that. So I think those are a lot of the biggest pros for circular style filters. Now, as far as the cons are concerned, you know, with these types, square, rectangular style, these are not cheap. It's probably going to be a more expensive system for you. The filters aren't cheap. You're going to have to get some type of an adapter set up like this to hold the different types of rectangular and square style filters to hold the polarizer in place. You're going to have to get the entire kit. So it's definitely going to be a little bit more of an upfront cost. These are less durable, as I mentioned as well. There's no edge banding. There's no protection around these types of square filters. If you drop them, they probably will break. There is a potential for light leakage. So if you don't get these filters in straight in the adapter holder here, maybe you have one in the bottom section and then maybe you have the right side of the filter in the middle section here. A lot of times it'll put it on an angle, and if you're not paying attention, a little bit of light can get in and that can definitely ruin your photograph. So there is a potential for light leakage right there. And it's just more to carry around. So I think that those are really the big cons, because I mean, you're obviously going to have to carry the filters. You're going to have to carry the actual filter setup right here, or filter holder. Then you got your polarizer as well. Maybe your step up ring. That's what I was trying to think of earlier. These are called step up rings or adapter rings that give you the ability to attach these to, you know, various different thread sizes of your lenses. So those are really the cons that I came up with for square and rectangular style filters. As far as round filters are concerned, probably the biggest con with circular style filters is the fact that there could be some vignetting, because these filters do not extend out beyond your lens barrel. So there is a potential for some vignetting, especially if you're using some type of an ultra wide or wide angle lens. When you have it at its widest focal range, there's a chance you could get some darkening of the corners when you use these style of filters. There is, sometimes you have a lens. I had one lens that did not have, actually two lenses, that did not have any type of filter threads associated with it. And if you only have screw-on filters, you're not going to be able to adapt that. If you have this type of a filter system, you could adapt it to that specific lens as well. So that's something to think about. And then the other thing is with these types of filters, square and rectangular filters, this is a medium graduated filter. And I have seen some screw-on filters that are a graduated filter, and they kind of have the graduation in the middle and you got to kind of line it up. I tried one out before. I found it to be a little bit cumbersome to use. So I guess you could say that that is a con, that there is no graduated filter. But honestly, I find that I use the graduated filters not nearly as much as I use a polarizer or a solid ND anymore anyway. So I'm trying to think if those were all the pros and cons that I came up with. I believe there is. And like I said, there probably are a couple that I didn't mention, but those are the ones that I've really noticed over the years. As far as the pros and cons from using a square and a rectangular style filter system versus a circular screw-on filter system. I think both are fantastic. Both of them definitely have a little bit of downsides to them. Just really depends on your personal workflow, the style of system that you're using, and how you want to operate. Do you want to screw your filters on? Do you want to slide your filters in? Do you stack filters? Do you never stack filters? Do you only use a polarizer? It really just depends on each individual's workflow. So those are the pros and cons from my personal experience. And like I mentioned at the beginning of the video, if you are looking to get your first filter system, or maybe you're looking to upgrade your current filter system, I hope the information in this video will help you to better assist in your future buying decision. And as always, if you have any questions about any of this stuff, definitely leave me a comment in the comment section below, and I guarantee I will get back in touch with you as soon as possible. And if you did enjoy this week's video, if you could give it that thumbs up and subscribe to the channel if you're not subscribed already. And as always, I really do appreciate you watching this week's video, and I will see you all next Wednesday. Bye.